Hello everybody, today we are going to start with the second chapter from your Footprints Without Feet, that is a thief's story. We have already covered with the first and today we are with the second topic, the thief's story by Ruskin Bond. Now, before we proceed, we will have a chapter at a sketch. The thief's story is about a 15-year-old boy whose name is Hari Singh, whose life changes when he meets Anil, a 25-year-old writer. Anil's unspoken words and kind gestures leaves a very positive impact on Hari Singh's life. In this chapter, we have two main characters. One is Anil and one is Hari Singh. This story has a simple plot with an important message. There is a small-time thief who befriends a struggling author in the plans of making a steal. Anil, the struggling author, is a good fellow who wants to teach Hari how to read and write. The story focuses on human values and relationships. It is easier for a thief to burgle a greedy man. It is difficult even for a thief to burgle a careless and honest person. Before we go for the summary, we will have a brief look at the characters. Hari Singh, who is a 15-year-old fair-handed thief, he is keen on learning how to read and write. He is so experienced robber that he knows how different people will react when they are robbed. Anil, on the other hand, he is a 25-year-old, tall, lean man. He earns his living by writing, as he is an author. He is a kind, simple, and easygoing person. Okay, so here we begin with the main story. This story is about two different people. As I told you, one is a thief of 15 years of age, a young boy, and the other is a man approximately of 25 years. Watching a wrestling match somewhere. The name of the person watching the match is Anil. The thief approaches Anil and starts talking to him because he feels that he had not robbed anyone in the past few days and thought that it would be easy to rob a simple person like Anil. So here, when Anil was busy watching a wrestling, Hari Singh comes to him and he starts talking to him and from past few days he has not robbed anything. He's a robber wherein he just happens to make friendship with simple people and then he tries to steal whatever they have with them and then he escapes with all different types of names. Now Hari Singh is not his actual name. Every time he meets a new person, he starts keeping a new name for him. So this time, when he met Anil, he kept his name as Hari Singh. Now they both started talking and Anil asked the thief his name. He introduces himself as Hari Singh, which is not his real name as he changes his name every month to escape his ex-employees or the police. If he has the same name keeping every now and then, it would be easy for the cops to catch hold of him. So he did not want to come into contact with the police. He just wanted to escape from every employer where he used to go, stay for some days and steal all the things and move from one place to another. This was his job. So this time he happens to meet Anil and they start talking about the wrestlers. And Anil was leaving when Hari called him again and asked if he could work for Anil. So now he trapped Anil because he wanted to steal Anil's money or whatever he had. So he thought Anil was a very simple person and he would be easily trapped with in his plan. So what does he do? He makes friendship with Anil and he says that if you are alone, I can just work out for you. Whatever you say, I am going to work for you, doing all sort of things for you, taking care of you, cooking or whatever it is possible. Anil said he won't be able to pay him but could feed him if he knew how to cook. So Anil says, as I'm a small author and even I'm struggling in my life to earn a good lump sum amount. I cannot pay you a good amount, but if you really know to cook for me, I can feed you. And Hari lied that he knew how to cook. So Hari said, yes, I know how to cook and I will be able to cook for you. Anil took Hari to his room, which was above a sweet shop. Hari took a meal which was really bad because Anil did not eat it. So he did not know to cook actually. But he just lied that he knew to cook because he just wanted to be with him and just study Anil. What does he do? Where does the money come from? So that one fine day he can just rob all the things and escape from there. Anil asked Hari to leave, but he tried to please Anil. Hari smiled. This is in his most attractive way and Anil could not stop laughing looking at him. So when he did not cook properly, Anil said, see, I had told you that if you really know to cook, you can stay with me. But Anil, when he saw Hari Singh smiling and in the most attractive way, Anil could not stop laughing looking at him. And he said that he would teach Hari how to cook. Even he told Hari that I would teach you how to read and write, because he was a 15-year-old boy, you can say, who did not know how to read and write. Anil thought if he really teach him all these things, that would be really helpful for Hari Singh to earn his livelihood in his future. So he thought of teaching him how to cook and even to read and write. Hari was grateful as he knew that he would be no limit of robbing people once he learned how to read and write. So even Hari was very happy because he thought that if he really knows how to read and write, he could get rid of his robbery and he could earn his living, maybe earning somewhere, having a decent job. So he agreed staying there and agreed to Anil when Anil offered him to teach him how to read and write. So he was very happy. The narrator used to like working for Anil, as he used to make him tea in the morning and then go out to buy groceries for a day. So now both of them stayed in one house, and the narrator, that is Hari Singh, he was very happy staying with Anil because Anil was a very pleasing and very, what you can say, a very respectful person, a very honest person, you can say. And working with him, narrator also was very happy. Now he started making him tea in the morning and he used to go out to buy grocery for a day. And he was Anil was very helpful and a very decent person. So all his behavior started attracting Hari Singh day by day. He also used to steal 1 rupee from the money that was given to him to buy the groceries every day. After all, he was a small time robber. So whenever he used to see a little bit of amount in his hand, he couldn't resist his temptation. So whatever amount was given to Hari Singh to buy some things, to buy some groceries, out of that, every time he used to keep aside some amount, that is 1 rupee, 2 rupee, whatever it is. And then he used to go out with his friends and enjoy. But Anil did not point out to for his stealing of any money. He knew that because he used to keep the account, how much money was given to Hari Singh, how much money he spent for the grocery and how much money he kept it for himself. But he did not ask him for the amount which he kept for him. Neither he asked him for, what was he doing with the amount where he was stealing off. So he knew that he used to steal, but he said, a small boy, doesn't matter, maybe he has some wish or a desire to buy something, he must have taken. So thinking that, Anil was quiet. Anil used to make money by irregular works. Sometimes he used to borrow money in the other way. Other day when he had money, he would be lending it to people. Whenever he used to get money, he would go out with friends to celebrate. So once what happened, Hari Singh saw Anil bringing a bundle of notes and told Hari that he had sold a book to a publisher. So every time Hari Singh, whenever he used to ask money from Anil, he used to borrow from him. But the little bit of amount which he used to keep with him, he used to celebrate with his friends. So one day what happened, when Anil came with a bundle of notes and told Hari that he had sold a book to a publisher. So he had got a good amount of money, which he was very happy for what he had written as an author. At night, what did he do? Anil, he kept the money safely under the mattress of his bed. So under the pillow, he just kept the money and he went to sleep. So keeping that money under the pillow was seen by Hari Singh. He saw that there is a bundle of notes which Anil had kept it. Hari realized that he had been working for Anil for a month, for more than a month, and had not stolen anything apart from a rupee that he kept every day from the grocery money. So every time, whenever Anil used to give him some amount of money to buy the groceries, out of that only 1 rupee he used to just steal for himself so that he can enjoy with his friend. But now that today he saw Anil keeping a bundle of notes under his mattress, so he was tempted. He couldn't stop from robbing that amount. So what did he do now? Hari had many chances to steal as he had the key of the room as well. So whenever Anil used to go out, or even Hari Singh used to go to the market, he used to hand over the key to Hari Singh, saying that you clean the house, you prepare the food, you buy the groceries, and in the evening Anil used to return back. So Hari had the key of his room. But he was surprised with the amount of trust Anil had on him, as he had never seen such trusting person in his life. So one more thing. Now, so many people he came across in life, who? Hari Singh. But he did not see a person like Anil who had so much of trust on him. Every person he worked, he cheated them, he betrayed them, he stole, and he just ran away from them. But this person, Anil, was one such person who trusted so much of him. He actually handed over the key, and in front of him, he kept the money under the mattress. So, as and for now, we do not trust any servants in our house. But Anil trusted him, saying that he was his own close friend, such. So, when he thought of robbing those that amount which was kept, he started thinking that he did not find such a trusting person in his life till now. So this trust thing was preventing him from robbing Anil. So that dual mind started working in his mind. He said whether I should rob or whether I should not. First and foremost, I'm a robber. I should not get messed up with relations or such things. I should rob and just run away from here. But on the other hand, he started feeling that soft touch for Anil, because the trust which he had, because the confidence level, the confidence which he showed on Hari Singh. Anil had a lot of confidence as well as trust on Hari Singh. So this, all the things which he started thinking made him stay aback from robbing Anil. As Hari thought that robbing a careless person like Anil didn't make much difference, because he might not even notice that he had been robbed, and that took out all the fun from the work. So he's saying, he's such a careless person, and I don't want to rob such a careless person, because he might not even notice that he had been robbed, and that was not a fun which he will have in his job of robbery. Then he thought of stealing Anil's money and justify himself that he didn't steal money from Anil, and then also he would waste it on his friends, and Anil didn't pay him for the work he did it. So now, on the other hand, he started thinking, why I should think all these things now? Who am I of him? Or who is he of me? My job is to steal. My job is to rob the amount and just enjoy my life. So why am I thinking all these things? So what did he think now? He said he started thinking, I'm going to steal the money from Anil. And that too, Anil is not paying him for the work he's doing. He's just kept him in his house and he's feeding him. And whatever the amount was given to him for the grocery, 1 rupee he used to just take him from his for his enjoyment. So that's it, was Hari's life with Anil. As such, he was not paying him any monthly, daily wages or a monthly salary for him as he was working for him, because Anil had already committed that he will not be able to pay for him. So he's saying, anyhow, he's not paying for me, then why should I think about him? So let me just concentrate on my work. That is, I should rob and run away from here. Hari then woke up at night quietly and crawled to Anil's bed. He steals money and decides to leave the city by Lucknow Express that departed at 10:30. So now at night, he made a plan. When Anil will go to sleep, he'll just go to Anil's bed slowly, and he's going to steal the amount what was there, and he's going to just run away from there to leave the city by Lucknow Express, that is by train. He's just going to disappear from there and he's not going to come back, because he will not know where Hari Singh is already gone. When he reached the station, So before that, what did he do? Now he crawled to Anil's bed. The mount which was there, which was kept under his mattress, slowly he just removes it and he moves out of the house and he just goes and sits on the station. The train had slowly started moving from the platform. He could have easily caught the train, but he hesitated and himself did not know the reason for it. Now, you can see the change in Hari Singh, but slowly, slowly he's getting through it. Initially, he said that he's not going to rob because the inner conscience started telling him that he should not rob because Anil had shown so much of trust on him. But on the other hand, he said he was not paying, so why should he think about all that? So he robbed, he stole him. And what did he do? He ran and sat on the platform. But as the train started moving from the platform, he couldn't easily move and catch hold of the train and run away from them. He started hesitating, but he himself did not know what was the reason for it. That was his inner conscience started asking him that he is cheating him, his own self. He's cheating Anil because Anil has shown so much of trust on him. Anil has shown so much of confidence on him. And why am I cheating him all the way? So that feeling stopped him from going from there. Before he had reached the station, he counted the money. It was 600 rupees in 50 rupees note. He could live a lavish life for 2-3 weeks with so much of money. So 600 rupees were more than enough for a small-time robber just to enjoy their life, eating, sleeping and enjoying. But he could not take a step forward. Every time Anil's face and Anil's trust stopped him from doing all these things. After the train had left, Hari was all alone at the train station. He was left with no place to sleep at night. The only person he knew was Anil and he had looted him as well. So he did not have anyone in the city and train is already left now. He was all alone on the station. He could not go anywhere. He could have just ran away from there, but he did not. Now the only person he knew was Anil, but he had looted him. He had robbed a mount from him. So how could he go back to him? So he started thinking what to be done. He sat on the bench in a park and at the same time it started to rain. So what happened? He started thinking hard now. What to do? Shall I go back or shall I go from here? He was not understanding what exactly is to be done. And the same time it started raining heavily. And whatever notes he had in his pocket, because he was totally wet and the notes also got wet in the rain. He realized that learning how to read and write would help him to get much more respectable and honest job, which would pay him much more than these few hundred rupees. So finally, he came to a conclusion. Anyhow, Anil is a very honest person, a very helpful and kind person. So if I stay with him, he has already started teaching him how to read and write. He's taught him how to cook food. So if I learn to read and write, that would give me a respectable and honest job rather than moving from one person to another person, stealing and robbing all the things. So what is there in such life? I may enjoy just for a few days, but I don't have a respectable designation. I am a robber after all. So he thought of going back to Anil and learn how to read and write from Anil. So then he decided to go back to Anil's house. He reached the room and placed the money back. Next morning, he woke up a bit late and Anil had already made his tea. So the thing is, he came back to Anil's home. He did not make any sound. Anil was sleeping. And what did he do? The bundle of money which he had and which was already wet, what did he do? The same way how he had stolen the amount, the same way he placed the amount under the mattress, thinking that Anil is not going to know anything. So next morning he woke up a bit late because the full night he was moving from one end to another, and Anil got up early morning and he made tea for himself and for Hari Singh also. And Anil just kept quiet as if he doesn't know anything. Anil gave a 50 rupee note to Hari Singh and as he had got paid for some work and he would be paid regularly. So what did he do now? Because the other day only he had got 600 rupees for his book which he had written from a publisher. Till now he was just struggling and he did not have enough money to give Hari Singh. So now that he has got money, so out of that 600, 50 rupee note he handed over to Hari and he said that till now I have not paid you anything. And henceforth, you will be regularly paid from me. So take this 50 rupees as your payment. Hari took the note in his hand and realized that the note was still wet from the rain last night. Yes, because the full bundle was wet as he got wet in the rain, and the note which was handed over by Anil to Hari Singh was still wet. Hari realized that Anil had come to know about his misdeed, and there was no sadness, anger or guilt in his mind. So Anil already knew that Hari Singh had robbed his money, but he did not run away. He came back. That means he had that guilt in his mind that whatever he was doing was totally wrong. So he came to know that the robbery, the stealing, what he was doing will not lead him to a very successful life. So he planned to change himself. So these all things made Anil not to blame him or not to be angry on him or not to point out his mistake, because Anil thought that anyhow Hari came to know his own mistake and he has already decided to change and be a good person. So why he should again point him out for the mistake he has done? So he just kept out knowing everything, whatever was done last night. The narrator smiled in a beautiful way, and it was a genuine happiness as he knew that he had saved himself from a wrong road. Yes, the narrator, that is Hari Singh, was so happy that Anil, knowing everything, did not scold him, did not be angry on him. And he had that genuine happiness knowingly that he will try to improve himself now, because Anil already started teaching him reading and writing. So with that point of view, he is going to have a successful life ahead, he thought. And he came away from the wrong road which he was moving till now. So this was the end of the story. So here we come to know that the main moral of the story, which is written by Ruskin Bond, named The Thief's Story, focuses on human values and relations. So yes, if you have good human values, if you have a weightage for relations which are important in life, that can really change a person who has gone on a wrong path. So what usually we say, that if a person is doing something wrong, maybe he should be punished or he should be behind bars. But at times a person's nature, good behavior, can also change a bad person to a good person. So this is what we learn from this story. Hari Singh has completely changed only because of Anil's good nature. That is, his unspoken words and kind gestures, and which had a very positive impact on Hari Singh's life. That is, Hari Singh is a character who is a thief, and he though robbed Anil, but he couldn't run away with his money, as Anil was honest and a genuine man. So in life, human values and relations are very important to change a bad person into a good person. So this is the end of the chapter.